Today, we're going to tangle with the toughest vegetarians on the block, the buff bream. Ever seen those huge fish cruising around the rocks?
It's loose again! I can't believe it!
Today, I'll teach you how to catch them, but it won't be easy.
I'm not even in the battle.
It's a photo fish. That's what a buff bream is. Congratulations.
Thank you, Steve. I go fishing with Steve quite a bit. He rang me the other day saying he had this great new bait he wanted to try on the buff bream. I've never caught a big buff before and I'd love to. I've caught many fish, different species. I've caught sharks, snapper, jewfish, dolphin fish, you name it, I've caught it. But I've never caught a big buff. I can't wait to get into the action.
A mission like this one is going to need the right tackle, and that means Joe Palala's Ranger Outdoors in Osborne Park. I think they know my credit card number by heart now. Paul was dead keen to go light tackle on the buffies, but I tried to convince him he'd need a 10-footer with a serious kick in the butt. I'm not sure he believed me, but he certainly agreed on the line. Braid or gel spun like Fireline will give us the edge on the big 10 pounders that charge at the reef and also resist the sharp edges of the rocks they live around. Hook wise, we go small, with the smallest worm G-locks we could find. Octopus hooks are pretty good too, but keep them small, around a number 8 or number 6. Leaders are essential, with fluorocarbon being almost a must. You'll hook more of the shy fish with a 6 pound, but they'll bust you up, so be prepared to go as high as 20. With the heavier leader, you'll wait longer for hookups, but be in with a better chance of actually landing them. It's a fine balance. Sticky burley made from pollard, water and flour is going to be our bait, but it's also a good idea to get some pellets to fire them up. I'm always scamming trips on Paul's boat, so I thought I'd spring for this big dollar haul. It's cheaper than boat fuel anyway these days. Shore-based fishing is becoming a serious option to save money. Hillary's Marina is one of the best fishing platforms in Perth. It's easy to fish and home to loads of smaller fish for the family to chase, but there's one big sucker down there that's not so easy to catch.
This is the southern wall of the Hillary's Marina. Now, it could be any marina or rock wall in WA. There's buffalo bream all over the place. I've chosen this one because we're close to the water and it's very safe, easy to land the fish. Sometimes you're up high, they're really hard to land. That is a big ball of the pollard, flour and water bait I made yesterday. And that is my quill float. Now, we don't use quill floats very often in WA. And this one's just tied to my main line, which is Fireline. I'm using 14 pound because frankly, these things can go like trains. My lead is long. 5, 6, 7 foot long. And that's 10 pound fluorocarbon and one of my smaller hooks on there. Now, I'm not gonna put this enormous piece of bait on that small hook. I'm just going to take a little piece, about marble size, and just squish it around. That's why we use the flour in the burley mix, to make it nice and sticky. And that's my bait. Pretty easy stuff. Now with the rest of this stuff, I'm going to break off little pieces of bait the same as mine. Buff bream, they're actually really smart, and they've got great eyesight. They can see your leader, they're very shy. What I'm trying to do is show them that bits of bait that look like that are absolutely safe to eat. I've got about 10 pieces in the water. Here's the easy bit. Well, not falling in is the hard bit, but I think we've probably got that covered for now. I'm gonna turn around. We're not gonna cast 1,000 miles. Literally gonna roll my arm over. The float's only 10 feet out. And the quill will tell us when it goes under that we've got a bite. Oh, Paul, I saw that one. Paul's quill went whoop, but he didn't hook up. Soft bait, so they will get them off. You've got to be patient. Not my specialty.
The tide for buffalo bream fishing doesn't matter at all. High, low, rising, falling, it's all the same to them. The moon phase doesn't seem to make any difference either, nor does the time of day. However, I like to fish in the middle of the day so I can use the sun to see where the fish are at. The wind direction and barometer also don't affect them overly, unless they create storms, swell and dirty water, which the buff don't like at all. Always try to pick a day where the water is very clear so you can fire them up with burley.
The buffalo bream, it really does have a terrible reputation in Western Australia, and it's only because they're bad to eat. And that's because they're vegetarians. Not just vegetarians, but vegetarian gardeners. They actually tend to and defend their own patch of weed and kelp around the rocks. And fish that might only live 50 metres or so up the rocks and are not part of their school, they'll actually defend the weed against them. Look at that tail. A big C-shaped powerful tail. These fish go like the clappers, and that's why I love to catch them. And with a fish that grows between 10 and 15 pounds, at your local marina, why wouldn't you want to try and catch it? Let's see if we can.
I'm on. Yes. Go, go, Paul, go. Oh, net time. Oh, the net's up on the rocks. Oh, hold on to me, mate. It's a good one. Hold on to him. I'm coming. If you like a bit of pandemonium, this is definitely the way to fish. All right.
Oh, it's a good fish, Steve.
Now, this is going to test my much talked about netting skills. Oh, keep him out of that weed. Keep him out of that weed. Oh, my shoes have gone underwater. Oh, no, you're on the rock. He's out, he's out, he's out. I don't know how to say this, mate, but you've got to bring him this way. And you've chosen your bream rod, so handy. Oh, keep out of that. Oh! Hooking them's one thing, landing them is quite another. We'll get one. This is why I got the long rod, mate.
After the break, we work out the smaller ones.
I think we might even get a look at this one.
They've got very small mouths, and that's why I've got the small hooks.
But the big vegans still give us curry. Oh.
If you'd like some insider fishing knowledge, why not pick up a copy of my book called How to Catch a Fish? Inside the 160 pages with 200 fantastic fishing photos, you'll find all of my secrets about fishing in Western Australia and across the whole of Australia. It's only $15.95 and you can pick it up at a newsagent or your Ranger Camping and Outdoor store.
Yes, I'm on.
Nice one.
Oh, it's a good fish.
Okay. Oh, he's pulled it. We're going to land one. We're going to land one.
I wasn't so sure about Paul's light bream tackle for these things. I was using my surf outfit and still having trouble.
Yep, on.
Oh, good fish, mate.
No, not fantastic, but I think we might even get a look at this one. The patience required is more than I normally have. All right, this time the net. Oh, gotta catch the rocks. Finally, we've got one. Now leave it in the net just for a minute. They've got a nasty habit, these buff, of evacuating their bowels, I'll just say. So we'll let him do that, and then I'll pick him up and show you.
They've got very small mouths, and that's why I got the small hooks. And being vegetarian, you can trick them if you use the right bait. I've caught them on prawn, I've caught them on muleys, but that bait, the thing that we made at home, it's done the business. It's a small one, but
He's gone back in and I'm going to try and get a big one. What about you? Big one?
Yeah, I can't wait to get a big one, Steve.
Well, easy enough to say, but with that tackle, what chance do you reckon he had?
Yep.
Oh, you almost did!
Yeah, I know! I'm standing on the same rock as you are. I'm trying to be bad. Nick isn't available.
Oh, bloody rock. Get out of there. Oh, damn it. Oh, good one. Good fish. Oh, no, again.
It loops again.
I can't believe it. I'm going to throw myself in. Maybe not, but still.
Come on.
You got him, yes.
No, it's garbage.
It's a herring.
I don't mean to laugh, but even I look stupid that time.
Oh, it's under. I've got him. Oh, he's
out. That's what happens when you got too much burley in the water. You get a herring.
Well, at least he's landed something. Oh, I should have shut up. This is making herring fishing look ridiculously easy. No more burley.
No more burley indeed, but with just the right amount, it was looking much better, and the fish were totally fired up, taking everything but our baits. They're incredibly smart, but sooner or later, the stupid ones make a mistake.
Come on. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm going to get him over the lip. Oh, I tell you what, there's no turning them if they don't want to turn, no matter how big they are. All right, I've got to get in the water. Hey.
Oh, Bream fishing. You wouldn't have thought it'd be this exciting, would you?
But it is.
Well, Paul, this size fish seems to be quite easily fooled and landed, but it's the big ones that are really hard.
Yeah, Stephen. I mean, that's not even close to what I had before that I lost, but here's hoping I can get another one.
Well, let's hope you can get a really big one, because there's some down there, literally like this. Some 4 or 5 kilo fish down there. This one's about a kilo. He's sharp on the bottom. That's what I'm using the bogey grip, so... Bit of a quick release again. We'll try and get a big one. They go down, they come up. There's no bait or there's no hook. We'll get one, though.
Well, that swell's getting up a bit. And actually, as often happens, I can still see the fish down there, but they're not fired up anymore. They sort of know what we're up to. They are pretty smart. We caught some smaller ones, but Paul's on a bit of an untouchables and he's turned up to a gunfight holding a knife. We're going to go home, rig him up with something stronger. Maybe change our plan of attack a little bit. See if we can't get one of the bigger ones tomorrow. Is that all right so far?
Yeah, big one.
Up next, our sneaky old change of tactics actually works. Well, sort of.
Oh, he's gone around every rock in the building. And the quarterback is toast.
But frustrating too. We actually went home and worked out a lot of the fish we lost were actually bite-offs, not bust-offs. Using lighter leaders to pull them, we were using 6 pound and then 10 pound fluorocarbon, they're actually biting us off. So we've gone home and come back with 20 pound fluorocarbon, also made a slightly stickier burley, a bit more flour in this mix, just so it's more doughy and stays on the hook better. Paul's also got his 10 foot rod and slightly heavier mainline, and today he's going to catch a fish. Here's the bait we're using today, and some people will call it burley because it actually is. This bait is doughy as, just like plasticine. It's my special secret buff bream mix. Now I make it by pouring in 2 cups of pollard, 1.5 cups of flour, and then putting water in until it's nice and sticky. It needs to be sticky to stay on the hooks. If it's all crumbly, the fish will get it off straight away. It's no use to anyway. So we put a little ball like that on the hook, not too much, just a tiny little bit. It sticks. See how sticky it is? Perfect bait for buff bream. Oh yeah! Yeah, big one!
Oh, hang on, Steve.
Oh, he's gone around every rock in the building.
And the quarterback is toast. I'm around a rock, I'm done. They are so strong. How do you land them?
Hopefully we'll find out.
Oh.
I have to say, this is some of the most challenging and downright frustrating fishing you can do because they're just so tough. They're tough to hook, they're tough to fool. They bite you off if you use a light leader. If you use a heavy leader, they spook. And if you do hook one, it trills you into the rocks. If there's a better type of fishing to do from the rocks with a fish that's always around them, I'd like to know about it.
Can't stay dry around here.
Don't worry, mate, I'm coming. You still got it?
After the break, we stop at nothing to catch a buff.
Yes!
Yes! That was a hit. Come on. Yeah, go Paul, go.
Good fish.
It's a good one?
Yep.
Sensational. Alrighty. Why do I always get the net job? You still got him on?
Yeah. Go for travel up the rocks.
Can you try and keep it in one place?
No.
Oh no. Oh, that's going around the rocks. What am I doing down here? I'm not even in the battle. Whoa. Don't worry, mate, I'm coming. You still got it?
No, I've still got him.
Have ya?
Yeah.
Don't do this at home, folks. Leave it to professional idiots like me. I'm coming, mate, I'll get there. Oh. Oh no, your leader's around a rock. Get the fish. Ah! I've got the fish.
Yes!
I've got the fish. Hey! Oh, oh, wow! I need that one up the back passage, but it's worth it. Oh, man. Come here. Let me shake your hand. Commitment. Battle. Big buff. That is what I call catching a fish.
You're not going to do it much tougher than that. I can't believe he didn't fall in. But a man will do strange things after 48 hours of getting fixed up by a school of fish. Needless to say, don't try salsering over the rocks yourself.
Down here, mate. I know it's easier said than done, but
I pretty much turned him and beat him. I need that net ASAP. Wind down, lift up. You're not frying chips, mate. Whoa, yeah. I couldn't go home without getting both for myself. Woo.
Well, it's a photo fish. That's what a buff bream is. Yeah, you can't eat them, but with a battle like that, why wouldn't you come to your local rocks and do this just like I have? Buff bream fishing at Hillary's. You can't beat it. Well, that's it for this episode. I really hope you learned something along the way. If you'd like to learn more about fishing anywhere in Western Australia, I've written a book called How to Catch a Fish. It's full of everything you need to know to catch fish anywhere in Western Australia. Pick it up from your newsagent or ranger camping stores for only $15.95. I'll see you next time on How to Catch a Fish.